Hello there, a very good morning to you. You're watching Proactive London, and today we're discussing Deepverge because they recorded the best quarter in their history, making progress on all fronts. And we're going to talk about each one of those with Gerry Brandon now. Very good day. How are you?
I'm very well, thank you. And belated happy Easter, but it was a nice and relaxing one for us all, hopefully.
Indeed it was. Yes. Well, no rest for the wicked because we're getting straight back into it because there's plenty to talk about with this announcement. So first of all, congrats. Sounds like a great quarter. We'll talk about all of that and much, much more. But kind of tell us how this was achieved and maybe go through the quarter and what exactly happened, because there was a real mix across the business, wasn't there, here?
Sure. I think, you know, it's important for me to clarify that this is year four. So, and, you know, we've actually done 100% plus every year since we actually began back in 2018, I think August 2018. So we're into year four at this, you know, 100% plus growth. And it looks like exactly the same this year. And it's all because of, I mean, it's a team effort. You know, there are over 80 people in the organization. There are multiple divisions. The environmental division is totally separate now from the skincare lab skin division. Even though there's still crossover with some of it, they're two separate entities. And they have just been on fire. You know, we've actually looked at this from the point of view of a societal problem on the skincare side and a societal problem on the environmental side. And, you know, the demand has actually grown substantially over the last year. As we headed in here, we already had a backlog of orders going into quarter one. And, you know, as you said previously in an RNS a few weeks ago, we have orders of 5 million going into quarter two. So it is continuous building on a recurring revenue model. So it's easier to sell when last year's revenues will repeat this year. That's pretty much the way the system is actually working and continues to grow.
All right. And you have announced this morning an agreement with Microsaic as well. That's what we're talking about, because you already have an agreement with you. So how does this differ and what will it do to the business exactly?
Well, when we got interested in Microsaic, it was because they could add serious value to our detection system in the environmental sector, and also in the lab skin side of the business, adding different methods to our to extend into the clinical research organization side of the business with their compact Microsaic unit or Midas unit. Now, what is inside of Microsaic is 19 years of expertise in electronic engineering, physics, chemistry, and all of the things that were partly missing from some of the innovation within the Deepverge organization. So we've contracted them to upgrade to future proof our equipment in the modern water side of the business. So the COVID miniaturizing that, detecting much more than the pathogens that we currently have. And that is basically the deal that we have with Microsaic. So while we are concentrating and focused on the commercial side of it, which is actually massively growing the sales, we have taken some of the innovation and put it into Microsaic, for which they can do. And I mean, the beauty about it is they can do this for other organizations. So this is their biggest order to date in Microsaic. And, you know, we would see that by introducing that into their organization, they can do this for other organizations. And that's, again, we'll see their biggest year yet.
Mm-hmm. So do you expect to see further collaboration between the two companies then?
Well, yes. I mean, we've currently given them a contract to upgrade the COVID-19 stuff and the breath test stuff and the laboratory side of our business. We will most likely extend that to include the other pieces of equipment, whether it's actually the Microtox FX, which is the field model, the LX, which is the laboratory model, and other equipment to give us, you know, state-of-the-art Internet of Things, and include our AI into that system. So, you know, we're always going to be ahead of potential competitors in the market. So it's third party contract only. It's not a further integration. It's purely and simply a contract for services to them.
Mm-hmm. So it's an inter-party transaction. How important is that? And how do you kind of maintain independence across both businesses when working together?
Well, the related party transaction occurs because myself and Nigel Burton are both directors of Deepverge and Microsaic. And the wonderful part of that is that the knowledge that I have of what the capabilities are within Microsaic are able to be crossed over to the benefit of Deepverge, and obviously vice versa. The commercial side of Deepverge benefits Microsaic. Now, for the purposes of AIM rules, this is classified as an AIM rule 13, which is a related party transaction. And both myself and Nigel had to step away from any discussions or negotiations and have our head of engineering negotiate with the head of engineering in Microsaic to ensure compliance, get external quotes so that there was comparative, you know, it was market pricing. So that had to be done, which is why it took so long to pull the whole thing together. But there is no, I suppose, you know, crossover other than the fact that we know a lot more about each other, and that has made us much more capable of delivering what it is that we want, as opposed to, I hope they can deliver. We know what they can deliver.
Mm-hmm. You've given emphasis to the investment in marketing. How important is that right now? Will you kind of continue to push this investment in the coming year?
Well, yes. I mean, we have the luxury of having three routes to market. We have the B2G, which is business to government, with our environmental services. We have the B2B, which is the lab skin side of our business, where the services from lab skin go to the skincare manufacturers to qualify their products. And we have this, I refer to it as the Star Spangled Skin Trust. We have this consumers, business to consumer. So though, not only do we have multiple streams from each of those, we actually have a situation where the growth element of each of them partly rely on each other, but also are, and again, you've seen recently in our Forbes magazine, in the Stylist magazine, the PR machine has actually been switched on. So once you switch that on, it is a 6 to 9 month process. We're about 4 months in, so it will actually continue to grow almost by itself. So yeah, I mean, the growth in PR and marketing is going to remain substantial from here on in.
Mm-hmm. So about halfway through that journey then, from the sounds of it.
Very much so, yeah.
Let's talk about the Skin Trust Club, because that has really taken off. We've had many discussions about this one, and we can see the impact of the marketing there. We spoke about that last time. What is the conversion rate, though, to clients? What does that look like?
When you look at every other DNA testing company out there on the market, every single one of them, and we've named a number of companies that are listed on different exchanges. The big problem they have is the recurring sales opportunity. So you have to spend a substantial amount of money getting new business all of the time. So the difference with Skin Trust Club is there's an entire sales funnel, and that gives you the initial free test. When you actually have the results of that test, 82% of those people who have taken that test buy product on our marketplace. They use that product over a period of 3 months, and then they see the improved results on their skin, and they want to test and see if it is if it is actually better. Obviously, they'll feel better, but they want to know what the actual state of it is much better. So they buy more tests. That's when it kicks in. So from that point of view, 3 months later, they will purchase more and more products that we recommend. And here's the most fascinating piece of news that came out recently on a study of just under 1,500 women between the ages of 27 and 51 is that 63% of them, 63% didn't know what their skin type was. They knew, they thought they knew, but when they did the tests, you know, your mother will tell you, you know, oh, you've got skin like mine, it's oily, so therefore you should be using this, or you have dry skin, so you should be using that. And some of these people have actually found that they have dermatitis because of using the wrong product, because their oil, their skin type is actually different. So the major difference for us in seeing this is that they trust now the results of those studies. That gives us the ability to continue to sell more and more products to them. That's completely unlike any sales route to market that exists in there, because the person themselves is telling them what to buy. And that is why there's so much interest from outside of our company about Skin Trust Club.
And what do you mean by tier one customers?
Well, tier one companies, our customers, are companies like Unilever and Procter & Gamble, who are both clients of our companies. These are well-known national and international brands. And there are much more, many of which we've got NDAs, which we can't actually disclose. But certainly, these are major corporations who believe in what it is that we're doing.
Okay. Your investors will want to be hearing more about these collaborations and the ones for Lab Skin. Sure. When are you allowed to kind of tell us more about those and who they're with?
Well, when you'll find products actually on the marketplace of the Skin Trust Club, then it's obviously public knowledge and public domain knowledge. But these companies would be well known to you. You would probably have products within your bathroom shelves, stocked full of soaps, shampoos, and skincare products who are our clients. A lot of the actual products we're testing now will not necessarily be out on the market for another 18 months. So for them, when they market those products, it may well be that they will have verified or scientifically verified by Lab Skin stamped on the outside of those products. So this is the first time in the history of skincare marketing that they will have third-party scientifically proven positive impacts of your skin microbiome, which is a completely new category in skincare.
All right, let's move on and talk about the modern water division in detail here, because you sort of had movement across a number of fronts that we're going to talk about, bidding for ticket sales in the Middle East and South Asia. When will you know if you've won, and what are they for?
Well, some of them we've won, but they are deferred simply because it's a consortia. So these would be multi-million dollar or multi-million pound transactions, of which we would be, you know, above a seven-figure number in participating in them. But there are currently supply chain issues, not from us, because we've managed to pull all of our supply chain pretty much inside with the production of equipment in Glanico, outsourcing this development with Microsaic and sourcing our products as reasonably local as we possibly can. So we've seen what's coming and we've managed it ourselves. That said, a lot of the companies that we're working with, they haven't, and so are subsequently involved in supply chain issues. But there are multiple type bids that have gone through, are coming through, and it's only a matter of subject to the supply chain. So again, which is why we've said happily, you know, we're looking forward to our fourth year in a row of triple-digit percentage growth here.
Let's talk about trials. When do the trials for Modern Water's wastewater solution, when do they begin, and how long are they expected to last?
Well, you know, we've been able recently to disclose that we're part of the actual national government in the UK's Sentinel, you know, the growth in the Sentinel, which is the post-COVID Sentinel sewage system. And you know, we've got equipment installed and there are further trials. These trials are accumulating or aggregating data. You know, the equipment is bought and paid for, it's installed, The tests are monitoring are continuing, but it's the trials are on verifying and validating the data, certainly as far as the UK is concerned. But other trials in the US, US cities that we're working with, existing customer cities that we're working with in the US, these trials are going to be underway this year already. And preparation for equipment to be installed in some of them is underway. So again, we will be able to announce those certainly later this year. And they're the same type of trials that are actually currently underway in the UK here.
And what should we be looking out for in the next quarter?
More growth. I expect more growth. I suppose the next trading update obviously will be the year end accounts for 2021, which will have, you know, a massive amount of detail of what has actually happened in this quarter and the next quarter too. But certainly it's going to be substantial PR, both here and in the US. We're looking to further expand in the US because demand from our existing customers in the US requires us to produce lab skin and services directly in the US, which is why we're expanding the Delaware office. And because there's so much interest on the West Coast, we're further looking at the opportunity of cooperation or collaborating with a third party on the West Coast to provide the facilities there. I mean, that is the Silicon Valley mentality. Get it. I think that's the best way to describe. So you should be seeing a lot more US news coming in, certainly in the next quarter.
Right, sounds good. Gerry, thank you very much indeed from Deepverge here on Proactive London this morning.
Thank you, Katie. See you soon.